Hi everyone, my name is Justin Odisho, and in this video I'm going to be reviewing the Joby GorillaPod tripod with the Ballhead X attachment. So my first experience with Joby's GorillaPod type of tripod was with a smaller one that they made for iPhones or mobile devices. And while that was a fun accessory to have, I can definitely say that this GorillaPod Focus is leagues better in construction. It's solid and it can hold its weight in a professional setting with a DSLR or any type of heavier equipment. As you can see, it's got nice aluminum sockets with flexible legs that are sturdy, and they have these nice rubber grips on the end to hold onto surfaces. So you can even just hold it by the end of one leg and you can see things don't move around. They stay in place pretty well. However, the legs are also pretty easily flexible. So if you want to use this as a stand or a grip for your camera, it'll work fine. And also if you're looking to use it with a heavier DSLR, it can carry up to, I think it says 11 pounds on their website. So I've got a Canon 70D here with a Rode mic and all that, and it carries it just fine. So one thing to note about this type of tripod is that it stands only about 14 inches tall. So if you're in a wide open space, that might be one downside, is that you can't get a shoulder up shot. So you have to get creative with it, and that's the whole point of this tripod, is it's very flexible in use. You can put it on top of stuff, you can wrap the legs around poles and beams, and this allows you to get different angles and add a very powerful variety to your toolkit or your camera bag versus a traditional tripod. I've owned this tripod for about 6 months now, and I've wrapped it around tons of stuff and used it often, and the legs are still strong yet flexible, just like when it was new. Now, taking a closer look at the actual Ballhead X attachment, this is where you get a lot of the functionality and versatility that take this from a regular bendy tripod to a really nice professional level piece of gear. So it's got a full 360 degree rotating base with markers at each 90 degrees. And if you turn this larger knob, you can access the ball head rotation. Now, if you haven't pushed it open in a while, it can be a little stiff at first, but once you get it free, it's really fluid and smooth of a ball head rotation compared to any other tripod I've used. It also has this little slot here for you to get full 90 degree positioning. Now, screwing the ball head back into place to secure its position, it's a very sturdy and solid feeling ball head piece. So I don't have any worries that my camera is going to fall loose and break, or that I'm going to compromise any of the gear that I have on top of it, even if I pick the tripod up and move it around. Like I said earlier, it's meant to hold up to 10 or 11 pounds of stuff on top. Another great piece that's part of the Ballhead X attachment is the quick release mount plate. So if you unscrew this, you can keep the quick release plate screwed onto your camera of choice. That way you could just slide it into the slot and be ready to go, rather than screwing in the entire piece to the camera every time. And this piece is also very secure when you tighten it. You don't have to worry about it sliding around and getting loose and possibly compromising any of your camera equipment. So if you're still confused about the Ballhead X piece versus the GorillaPod, what you see on the left is the GorillaPod Focus and the right is the Ballhead X piece. So if you check out the product page that I have linked in the description, you will see that there's an option to buy these two pieces separately, which I guess if you had one half already and you just need the other, you could do that. But if you're just looking to start out, I would definitely urge you to get the combo deal with both of them. It's 10 times more functional with the Ballhead X joint for only like $30 more, and you save 20 bucks when you buy them together rather than separately. In total, it comes in under $100, and it's probably the best $100 I've spent on camera gear in a long time. So I'll definitely have to recommend this to anyone looking to add some more versatility to their camera bag, and anyone who's looking for a good all-around tripod.
So thank you guys so much for watching. If you guys enjoyed this video, definitely subscribe to my channel to stay tuned for future videos. And if you guys want to check out this tripod, I'll leave a link in the description below. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.